So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you how to compare multiple months of data using PowerPivot. So I have tables for each month and ensure you that you have made them into a table. You can simply click on anywhere on the within the table and then click insert and then table. I've already got it as a table, so that's why it's grayed out. But so now that your stuff is in a table, what we're going to do is we're going to the Power Pivot tab here. To put it up into the Power Pivot, you are going to click in each table and you're going to add to data model. Now, I have already done that, but it basically you add every sheet, and then I have the sheet where the salesperson is related to the account number. It's on there. So now let's go to my data that's in the Power Pivot. So here you have, I've renamed these. It doesn't take the name that's already on your sheet. You have to rename them when they come up. So I've got March, April, May, and I'm not going to worry too much about July or June and July here. And the TT is my salespeople and the account number that they're responsible for. So then we went to the data view diagram. And what I did is I linked the number, which is the account number, to each of the account numbers within the tables so that we have a relationship between there. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to the pivot button on this tab here, and I'm going to go down and I'm going to select four charts. Now it wants to open it up on a new page, and that's just fine. So in the first chart, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click in here and I'm going to choose my salesperson table, and I'm going to put in the axis, I'm going to put the salesperson. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up and get the first one was March. It's not displayed here, but we'll go March. And what we're going to do is we're going to total the amount. So that's the sales for March. Now let's go down to April, and we will get the amount from here as well, and we'll put it in there, and then you can see the relationship between them. And then we will just do the third one, which is May, and once again I'm going to get the amount, and I'm going to put it in the sum of the values. So there we have what the sales figures are. So now what I'm going to do is I'd like to see in my other charts, I'd like to see what products they're selling. So I'm going to right click on this and I'm going to change the chart type, and I want a line. And I'll say okay. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going up to table one. I want the type as the axis value. So I'm going to put that in the axis value here. And I want the amount that they've sold under each type. Okay, so that's March values. Now let's go down and we can go into the other ones and create. And I'll create the same thing for table March, April, May. So I will create the same thing for April and May here. I'll just pause it for a second till I complete it. So I've completed doing all my charts here. Now the only thing that we need to do is change the chart title, because this isn't very obvious. So let's go March type. And we can, of course, do that to all the rest of them. So that's how you create a dashboard using PowerPivot, comparing multiple months of data. Please subscribe.